Good morning, friends. It's Sabbath spinning. Spinning is a relaxing activity for me and very meditative, very calming even. So I'm sitting outside in my backyard today and I'm going to share some of my spinning with you as you hear all the background noises from up here on Hamilton Mountain, living the urban life. The birds are singing. So what am I spinning today? I'm spinning this lovely floof, if you will. It's a roving merino in silk that I purchased last summer from Lori at the Black Lamb. And my target is to get this spun up this week so that I can ply it and cast on for my next sock. So let's get to work. So I think we have everything ready. This is my old Babe. I've had this wheel since back in 2003, 2004. It's traveled a long distance with me. It's old. It gathers dust and lint like crazy, but it still works. I just need to check to see if you can see what's happening here. And I'm just doing a fairly short draw. I keep my foot on the one side. It's supposed to be a double treadle, but we never got the second treadle to work right. So, and because I'm out on these old patio stones, it's not level. And I keep my foot on the other side just to keep everything leveled out. So what's going on in the background here? I hear a siren. There's some birds. We've seen a couple of really small greenish colored birds, which I think are some sort of warblers. There's been house finch. I've been hearing goldfinch, cardinals, mostly robins, but they're all busy with their nests today. I think it's pretty quiet. Our lawn hasn't been cut up yet, but it's still early. They suggest that you wait a little bit. We've got quite a few dandelions, so I might be picking a few to see if I can create a nice dye. There, I got that a little bit too thin, so let me fix that. There. So other than the sound of the wheel, it's not squeaking today. Some days it squeaks like crazy, but so far it's been pretty quiet. I love these colors and I'm hoping to do a chain ply with it to keep the separation of the colors as much as I can. We'll see how that goes. And then I'll adjust my sock pattern for the number of stitches in the gauge that I'll get from having a 3-ply as opposed to a 2-ply. The single ply is fairly thin, so, but I just don't believe it'll be thin enough to give me my size 2mm needle gauge that I normally use. I often use a 2.75 millimeter. Knitting needle for my socks. The ones I'm currently working on are a 2. So anywhere in between that would be wonderful. I don't want anything heavier than that though, if I can get away with it. And once I see, I'll do a swatch. Once I see how the pattern kind of comes up, I'll decide on the actual design of the pattern, whether it's just a plain vanilla or vanilla latte, which is an easy pattern for me to do. I don't have to watch my stitches too closely. I don't think I'll do a lace stitch for those socks, because then you lose both. You lose the lace and you lose some of the color as well. So just doing a straight knitting with a broken rib once in a while, that might be just what the doctor orders kind of thing. I'm just going to make sure that you're still seeing My hands are right here. So I'm sitting back in the chair, but I am doing a fairly short draw. So I get a worsted yarn and not a fluffy woolen, because the woolen just wouldn't hold up when I'm doing socks. And I got this specific blend, the merino silk, because it will hold up for socks. At least that's been my experience of it. And these are some of my favorite colors. It's got the blue, it's got the purple, and it's got a neutral color in there to break it up once in a while. So when I first started spinning, the first pair of hand spun socks I did were all spun on spindles. So I can't even imagine now spinning enough on spindles to make a pair of socks, because spinning on a spindle for me takes longer. Now, some people say that they can spin more on spindles because they can take the spindle everywhere, which is true. And when I wasn't doing most of the driving, I would spin while we were going places from here to there. And now I do all the driving, and I can't spin and knit at the same, or spin and drive at the same time. So there's a plane. Oh, it's a small one up above the Hamilton Airport. We're right in the line of the traffic, so the jets themselves don't come in here too low, but we always hear them. And you can tell, like, the neighbors are not out today. Everything's really quiet. On one side of me, every Thursday, the grounds people come in and cut the lawn and do the whippersnapper and stuff like that. And you just never know when somebody is going to be out working. Weekends, definitely. There's lawnmowers everywhere. Oh, there. I'm starting to hear a bit of a squeak. Also, I'm going to ask, because this is all plastic. It's a PVC plastic that's made the wheel. And over the years, with oils and all the fluff and what have you, I can't seem to get it clean, no matter what I try. So if you have an idea of how I could clean this wheel to make it look brand new, leave them in the comments below. I'd really, really like to know. Spruce it up a little bit. I have replaced the rocker plastic piece on the pedal. I did that about a year ago. And I've replaced the band on it a few times. But other than that, it's just going strong. Oh, and I got a new piece for the band here. Not a big deal, but definitely needed for replacing. And I've got that old music sticker paper in there, washi tape. So I need to remove it and do something different, maybe. Just something to make it feel like I have a brand new spinning wheel. So let me know. Please do comment. If you're interested in more spinning videos, also let me know that too. Because I want to do videos that you're interested in, not just the things that I'm interested in. There. Every once in a while I get really, really thin, and that's never a good day for me. I'm just going to sit back and spin for a few minutes while you watch. I actually like the momentum that I can get going. There for a second, I took a wee break and enjoyed my cold coffee. It's been sitting here for a while. I've been doing some brainstorming in my head, but maybe that's enough for today. You've been able to see what I'm doing and get an idea of how my spinning wheel works. So let me just see here. Pause. So I'm back. This is the first day in about 3 weeks that it's been warm enough to be sitting outside. probably close to 20 maybe. I'm looking at Nick to see 20 Celsius, maybe 22, 23. I'm not sure it's that warm yet, but right in the sun, out of the wind, it feels really nice. And I'm an outdoor person in that way. I like to be outdoors. The only thing that would make this better would be a fountain, a backyard pond with fish, or going to the lake, which is still an option this week. At some point we'll head either to Lake Ontario, Lake Erie. Lake Ontario's closer, but both drives are a little bit busy, so I have to be well rested and raring to go. But I thank you very much for joining me here today, and if this is the kind of video you like, please do give it a like, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe to my channel. And if you hit the notification bell, of course, you'll never miss it when I post a new one. On my channel, I post our weekly worship so that people who aren't able to attend worship can be part of that. I also post a lot about my sourdough bread and English paper piecing and knitting and just general life. So it's not one specific topic, but many. So upcoming videos, I'm doing one on a capsule wardrobe as I change out my late winter wardrobe into my spring / summer. And I'll be doing a clutter video, a declutter video. So I'll invite you to come with me as I show you before and after and some of the process that I'm going to be going through. That's a whole new thing for me. But we've been here now 2 years in June, and it's time to clean house again and get rid of all those extra things that we don't need. I'll also be talking about budgets and how to live on a frugal budget, save money, and feel comfortable with what we have. I wouldn't say I'm a minimalist, but I'm practical. So there'll be videos on those topics as well. So I hope you have a wonderful and blessed day. You can hear the finch. I can't see him, but he was definitely singing in the background. But I hope your day is blessed with whatever's wonderful in your life. Make someone else's day a blessing too. Till next time. Bye for now.